Welcome to Castle Loch, one of the last wild and untapped waters here in the UK. I started researching Castle in November 2015, having just moved north and already missing the lakes and the rivers of the south. I started to explore its shores, but knew it would be quite a while before the weather would be warm enough to go in search of this elusive carp. My first couple of sessions I moved around, trying to cover as much water as possible to get a good feel for what was going on beneath the surface. Castle for 4 nights saw me setting up on the north bank. As the past week had been considerably warmer and with big winds and heavy rain predicted from the southwest, it felt like the right place to be. The wind and rain had now cleared, and with 3 nights left of the session, it was time to keep exploring.
Under the bright sky. Your skin, and there's no way to get them all out. When it feels like rust seeping into your soul, stay gold, 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 stay gold, 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 stay gold, 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 under the bright sky. Sunshine.
between sessions, I'd used a boat to go in search of the carp. Locating them around 130 yards from the sewer bank, the baiting started. Seeing it in the head torch, it turned and the rig come flying back. 5 hours later, it was my dad's turn.
Here we are at Castle Loch. We're about to witness our almost record breaking fish from Castle Loch, caught today by another angler. Acres, handful of carp. Walked down here this morning to speak to a boy I just met, Stuart. He's had a couple of fish from Castle Loch, and lo and behold, when I'm standing chatting to him, his rod rips off. Hello. Hello, dear. Oof. Oofed. Spoke to my brother.
He says, don't tell anyone. I says, nah, he says, I'm allowed to tell one person, you, and that's it, keep it quiet. But he's like, oh, don't tell anyone. I says, well, don't tell anyone. But it's up to you. Happy days, mate.
It's scary to think there could even be more fish, but I mean, that's a beast. That to me could be the mother ship in here.
It's
not. It'd be a 40 pounder in here, eh? That's just.
I'll decide there is a 40 pounder in here, mate.
That's a stunning fish. See, to be honest with you, I've caught fish of that ilk out of the River Seine, and I've seen that kind of fish before, a wild gominy. But not in Scotland. I knew that could go 30. The back across it was incredible.
Yeah,
it was thick, yeah. But I mean, it certainly gave you a good run, but you got it in all right. I mean, a fish of that age is not going to beat you up like an 18 pounder would, or a 19. It'll maybe be more and deliberate, and then you just kind of re-kited a bit. I had a wee panic when I seen the size of it, right enough. I didn't want to say it's a 30. That's a good fish. Fucking cracker. Absolute belter. Hey dog. Hmm? Yeah, there's man with his prize. Happy days. Good angling. Fish gear. Just because it looks, it's such an old warrior, eh? It's a lovely shape to it. Proper common. I mean, 30 pound commons is a great fish in England, never mind Scotland. It's a two-tone.
Yeah, she's a lovely fish, too.
What are you going to call her, two-tone?
Big girl. I reckon that's a good name, mate.
It's a daddy, innit?
Oof. Do you hold up a chain with that, mate?
Of course, mate. There we go, back up.
Let's play a different game. Fire it all up again. Fire up my heart again. For me to lose. I know I'm the one to stay. I'll run away again. Running away again. Till I see the you.
Who I'd met in last summer in May, believed the carp were no longer here. But hearing the news of my 33-pound 8-ounce common, I had a feeling it wouldn't be long before I saw him again.